a DC-based think tank, Third Way, conducted a survey in 2015 and found more than 40 startups across the U.S. developing advanced nuclear power designs. These atomic business plans have lured more than $1 billion in investment.
I think a lot of it might just be the changing demographics of nuclear engineers, that now there are a large number of young nuclear engineers who think, I have a really good idea, I'm going to flesh out this technology, I'm going to raise some funding, I'm going to see if I can do this on my own.
How much do you have to worry about free fluorine formation?
Leslie Dewan is one of the young entrepreneurs leading this revolution.
Yeah, because that's what I'm hoping.
It's a new generation with a different outlook. Atomic power doesn't carry the same stigma for them. They are more concerned about powering the planet while addressing climate change. All of this led Leslie to MIT to study nuclear engineering.
This is a general trend around the world.
She was a grad student on the day the tsunami hit Fukushima.
It was especially shocking to me because when I first heard the news, I thought there are overblown media reports, but I trust that everything will be okay. But it went orders of magnitude beyond what I had thought the worst case scenario accident was going to be.
And yet she didn't waver in her goal to build a new kind of nuclear power plant.
It made me want to work even harder on developing newer types of reactors that don't have the same cooling requirements and that are even more robust in the case of even more extreme accident scenarios.
She became enamored with some nuclear technology first developed 50 years ago at another national laboratory, this one in Oak Ridge, Tennessee. It's called a molten-salt reactor. Not table salt, liquid fluoride salts. Unlike the TerraPower reactor that uses liquid metal to cool solid uranium fuel, this inventive design turns that idea around.
A molten salt reactor uses liquid fuel rather than solid fuel.
With liquid fuel, the size and shape of the container is crucial. Pumping the fuel into a cylindrical vessel places uranium atoms close enough to each other to sustain a nuclear chain reaction. If something goes wrong and it starts to overheat, the liquid expands and the uranium atoms become too dispersed to maintain fission. So it starts cooling down passively. And in the case of a total loss of station power, like Fukushima, the design employs another safety feature. Below the reactor chamber is an emergency reservoir. The drain leading to the reservoir is plugged by the same salt mixture, but it is refrigerated so that it freezes solid. Without electricity to keep it cool, the plug quickly melts, and the liquid fuel drains into the emergency reservoir. Unlike the reactor chamber, the shape and size of the emergency reservoir ensures the uranium atoms are too far apart to sustain a chain reaction. It cools down and eventually freezes, crisis averted. At Oak Ridge, they successfully ran and tested a molten salt reactor for 4 years. The design works.
Even in the worst type of accident scenario, even if you don't have any external electric power, like what happened at Fukushima, even if you don't have any operators on site, they're able to shut themselves down.
The basic science is well understood, but building a reactor that can withstand something as corrosive as a very hot bath of salt is a huge engineering challenge. It is the focus of early testing for Leslie's startup company, Transatomic.
We can make something that works for 5 years, that works for 10 years. Like that, we certainly know. What we're trying to figure out now is whether we can use newer materials or new methods of corrosion control to extend the lifetime of the facility. Because ultimately, we care about making this low cost. If you have to replace your key components every 10 years, it's not going to be cheaper than coal, and if it's not cheaper than coal, then it's not worth doing.
But coal and all fossil fuels carry another cost to the environment.